I just need some rest, she said, as if reassuring herself that it would work. As she reached to turn out the lights,
I love you, Lay.
There was a knock on the door of her hut. Figures, she mumbled as she made her way towards the door. As she opened it, she was startled to see many of the freedom fighters standing in front of her. One look at the faces told the princess that they were no too happy. No too happy, my goodness. Sorry. What's the problem? She asked. As if on cue, Knuckles the Echnida took it upon himself to be the group spokesperson. What's the problem? He said, irritated. The problem is that there is a lot of annoying noises coming from a certain fox's hut. I can't be even close my eyes long enough to even think about sleeping.
All right, calm down.
So he said, fine. I'll go take care of this. I appreciate it. The echidna said, I tend to let it get cranky if I don't get my beauty sleep. At this, Sonic the Hedgehog's not judging by how ugly you look right now. Maybe you should sleep for the rest of the year. He laughed. Knuckles turned around and looked at him, glaring through half-closed eyelids. If I wasn't so tired, I'd leave you right here now, he growled. As it is, I'm afraid I'd have to wait till tomorrow. Yeah, like I'm really afraid of you, Hedgehog said tauntingly. How would you like to eat dirt? The echidna shot back angrily, switching between a gangster and a Sylvester Stallone impression. Enough! Sally yelled, stomping her foot. None of us are going to have a sleep. Get and sleep at this rate. I'm going to go deal with our little disturbance, and I want both of you to knock it off until I get back, clear? The hedgehog and the echidna glared at one another for a moment. Crystal, Sal, Sonic said, turning away from both of them. Sally felt bad about having to curb Sonic's wild side, but it was too much too late for him to be arguing with him over petty remarks with Knuckles.
You're nothing but a big bunch of kids,
she thought to herself as she headed up towards the east end of the village. When will they grow up? As she rounded the corner
going to have sex?
Because of the late night disturbance. Chapter 2, Violent Fantasies. Oh shit, it's Vegeta and Tails, I just saw that. Tails exclaimed, jumping up and down on his bed.
There's no escape for you now!
Normally the Kitsune would have been fast asleep. Kitsune, what? But on this night he was wide awake. Candy wrappers littered the floor, and comic books were strewn together. Tails' eyes, however, were focused on one comic book in particular. This one was part of a series of action comics that Amy had gotten him interested in. She had read many of the issues, and she had lent them to Tails to read. From then on, the boy's mind was filled with images of epic struggles in faraway lands, ultimate battles between good and evil, and action-packed finales that accompanied each and every fight. As the Kitsune, Kitsune began to understand the characters more, he began comparing them to a few of his friends, the Not-Whole Freedom Fighters. However, this boy had begun to idolize one of the characters from the comic. In fact, he wasn't sure if Sonic was still his true hero, or if this new warrior had somehow knocked the Hedgehog off of his pedestal. Oh god, this is gonna be something with, like, Vegeta or something. This character was far from being cheerful and quick-spoken like Sonic was. He was blunt, sarcastic, and more arrogant than anyone Tails knew. He was determined to impose his will on others, oh god, to make him see as a better warrior than anyone else. In fact, Tails kind of wished that his hero would meet his Aunt Sally on account that they were both royalty. He was sure that the two would hit it off. The boy shook his head and continued reading on. So far, things didn't look good for the planet Earth. A super biological monster known as the Perfect Being had laid waste to much of the planet's population. Things had only gotten worse as the leader of the Earth Special Forces, whom his hero always referred to as Kakarot, had nearly succumbed to a viral heart disease and was recovering far from the battlefield. Now his hero, along with his son, had become training in a special zone as a hyperbolic time team.
Oh no, do great!
In order to combat the evil menace. Tails paused for a moment and grinned.
Robotnik wouldn't stand a chance against these guys!
He laughed.
But no, that was an actual trait.
The boy was so
Doom Crate crossover
that he wasn't even aware of Princess Sally standing next to him. At least until he looked up.
Oh, it's Sally!
He cried, dropping the book on the bed.
What are you doing here?
Wondering why you're making so much noise, the girl said. Tails, you're supposed to be asleep. Your sound effects are keeping the rest of the village awake. I won't stand your flapping.
Tails looked down at his hands.
Sorry, Aunt Sally,
he said quietly.
I'm was just getting involved in my comic.
What comic? The princess asked. The fox picked up the book and offered it to the girl.
This one,
he said. Sammy took a look at this. Not Sammy, Sally. Not Sammy, who's Sammy? Get out, Sammy. The Earth Special Forces were posing on the front with a big picture of the perfect being in the background.
Where did you get this?
She asked the Kitsune.
From Amy, Tails said. It's an issue of her favorite comic book series.
The princess flipped through a few of the pages. Many of them had images of people fighting and firing what looked to be energy blasts from their hands. So far, she wasn't too impressed with this literary value. The last image she saw then a press reefer depicted a young woman blowing a hole through the stomach of a young man from behind. Even though there was no color, she could easily guess what the dark spot just represented.
Tails, this comic is pretty violent, she said. You shouldn't be reading this at your age. But on Sally, what they show in there is no different from the violence we see when we take a robotic.
Tails protested. The princess looked at him for a moment.
Tails, she began. The difference is that our war with robotic is real life. It's pure fantasy.
The fox grinned.
On Sally, the bad guys in this story are way more
fans.
Hold on, yes, it will. Oh no, it doesn't. Oh well. Fuck Fox. This was awful. Oh, Sonic versus Goku. It is 855 words. Maybe this will be good. Sonic fights F-I-T-E Goku and will win. I wonder who will win.
Do we have any Doom crossovers?
No, there's no Doom crossover. But hold on, this is good.
What Sonic?
Sonic went to Tails' room and see him working on project.
Sonic,
how about the Doom crossover?
Yes. I heard about super people in the world Namek.
I heard about super people in the world Namek, said Sonic to Tails, started making portal to world and said,
oh,
Sonic, you need
stop,
the emerald.
Stop a second, Spangiel. You can't hear it because you have the music off, but the map we're in has some Sonic music.
Oh, cool. I'm just gonna go ahead then. Right here, said Sonic. So Sonic went to portal and see Krillin.
Who are you? Says Krillin. I come from different world, said Sonic. I come to see strong fights!
And quad dot.
Well, first you fight me,
says Krillin.
Well, I can win this fight.
So Sonic takes Emerald and beats Super.
Oh no, you are insane, says Krillin.
Yes, and I will win, said Sonic. Sonic teleports to behind Krillin and kicks him in back and Krillin flies.
I need to get help,
says Krillin. And leaves Sonic, goes back to normal, and he starts to run across the world looking for Goku and Vegeta and Piccolo for fights. Sonic runs fast and sees Bulma at capsule store.
I need capsule for fight, says Sonic.
Okay, Bulma said. So Sonic runs really fast to Goku, says as he's Chi-Chi.
Who are you?
Chi-Chi says.
I'm Sonic, where is Goku? Goku tree with Gohan Dark!
So Sonic run fast, but it's stopped by Piccolo. You are Sonic from another world, I will kill you fast, says Piccolo, but that's his evil strong. No, I will win! And Sonic kick Piccolo in face! Darn Blue Dark, I will win with light beams! So Piccolo shot beams at Sonic, but Sonic too fast for Piccolo. Grrr! And Piccolo grabs Sonic and throw him at the ground. Ouch, says Sonic. I need Heath! So Sonic used Capsule Land, was fast to punch Piccolo. Piccolo dead, and Sonic go away. He hold me back, now Goku go away, because Goku and Gohan were done training maybe, and now leave, Sonic says.
Holy shit!
Now Sonic may not fight Goku, so he needs to go fast. Sonic run real fast, I make it to house.
I am 10 and Yamcha!
Says them. Sonic try and run fast, but Tain make shield around Sonic. Yamcha kill him, so Yamcha make fist wolf and like kill. I miss, says Yamcha. And he goes back, Sonic makes tornado and spends Tain. No, don't! And then Yamcha saved Tain. We will be back, says them. And run Sonic ran to him and run too fast to make Goku. He fights and Gohan, then Vegeta flies by my life. Haha, stupid cat will die. This has got to be a troll. God damn it, this is so hilarious.
It's Hedgehog, Sonic said. Sonic fly to Vegeta to fight Vegeta, punish but to miss and miss Sonic, throw into air and kicks Vegeta and Wee Wee because it hurt there. Oh,
Vegeta cry. I will first never handle it. Vegeta says, Sonic granted buildings to buy capsules but has no money.
Have capsules free,
say girl cousinize. Well, Krillin first to fight more people because he need to win more. So Sonic went to find fights and win more. Stop right there, said Cell. Oh no, Cell, said Sonic. Sonic used Thunder to shook Cell, but it does work. What? Cell used punches to beat and win. Sonic went to Farstow. Cause Sonic kicked Cell and tell to hurt. Darn dog, said Cell. Dumb alien, said Sonic. You are no match for me. So Sonic wins. Sonic run fast like light and see Gohan. Gohan, where is Goku? Sonic says. Fight at sea, Gohan says. So Gohan, Kamahama, Sonic, and Sonic fell and hurt it. Ouch, Sonic says. Sonic then got super and used a spat to win. Darn Gohan, soy, I never lose. And Gohan goes sign. So Sonic and Gohan fight and punch to kick and win fight and blast wherever. Everywhere. And home destroy and city and building. Stop, you are destroying building, Sonic said. Sonic said. Okay, fine, I will tell you you are strong, Gohan say. Sonic found Goku and Park and he is eat food. Hi, Goku.
What?
I heard you're strong, so I come to fight, Onyx says. Okay, first you need to fight Freezer, Goku say. So Sonic run fast to find Frieza, because Sonic needs to fight Goku and win, but first need to win Freeze. Sonic go fight for freedom of Mobos. Cause Goku want to, I can win, Sonic says. Sonic run real fast to win to fight, win. And when Frieza sees Sonic and say, you are bad at fighting. Oh no, it's Frieza, Sonic says. Haha, try to fight me, hi. Frieza explains. Sonic goes super and Frieza made scarred because Frieza died one time. Oh no, not again, Frieza says. Sonic fly and punch. And Frieza yell, Frieza use tail whip and hurt Sonic, ouch you, strong! And Sonic fly to place to black like Namek. I need Shadow. And Sonic go, what? Shadow say, I need help. Sonic say, okay, I come to world and fight. Shadow say, I get two emeralds. Okay. So Sonic hang up, Frieza got mad and go on full 100%. Will Frieza win? Will Sonic win? Fight Fund. At next time on Sonic Ball Z! To be continued. I've gotta post this one in
that
the chat.
That was awesome.
Yeah.
You need to give the proper credit to the writer.
Oh, it's by the King of Ice. He has only written this one story. Let's look at the reviews. The Black Kitsune. Oh, you're doing the English? Oh, boring. Oh, there's one guy that says an absolute masterpiece. He is the only smart one. Oh no, he says the worst fanfiction. Damn it.
Oh, the worst thing about Sonic plus Dragon Ball Z is that a dude on the Newgrounds, I think, made a Flash series of videos. That's
yeah,
Super Mario Bros. Z, that's a crossover between Dragon Ball Z, Mario, and Sonic.
I'm gonna check again if there's no other stuff. There's no Doom, unfortunately.
No Doom at all?
I could do Doom fanfic.
Yeah, you just check Doom and crossover of Doom with something.
Yeah, I'll do that. Doom! Whoa. There are 8 Doom crossovers, let me check. A Nightmare on Elm Street, Buffy the Vampire Slayer,
what?
Lord of the Rings, Naruto, Red Wall, and Teen Titans.
Naruto?
Red Wall? What? Red Dawn?
Red okay. Wall.
Red well, you were Dawn. Saying Red Dwarf for a second.
No, no, no.
Because that would have been else.
Go Wolverine!
Nightmare, Lord of the Rings, Red Wall, Teen Titans, Naruto, Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
It's gotta be Lord of the Rings.
Okay, let's check. Oh, damn it, it's M-rated. Uh-oh.
Oh boy.
Oh damn it, it's 5,573 words.
What the hell?
Lord of the Rings Doom crossover. Highly explosive. Prologue. Arrival. March 27th, 2145. Fionn was yet again the commanding officer, or yet again captain, of another space mission. One that he had created. Fionn had hacked into the UK's military mission listings with great difficulty. He had to do it in the most secret place that was raided about an hour after he had left. Now he was the captain of a flight to another realm, his home realm, Middle Earth. He had grown up there. His family was there. The royal family of Rohan. Everything he knew and was brought up with had changed since he left Middle Earth and had gone to Upper Earth. But the locals just call it Earth. Earth. He had left because of a dream. He had a dream that every black man and every white man in Georgia would be together. No, he had a dream of the destruction of Middle Earth by dark creatures that seemed to crawl out of the nightmares of some twisted human being. And he had gone to Lord Elrond to seek counsel. Lord Elrond had told him of a place where the technology was strange and people controlled extraordinary metal beasts. So Fionn took his chance and traveled to Upper Earth when he was in prime for his life back 2120 in Earth years. What? He had been traveling on the largest space vessel in the pack that surrounded his ship. He had over 1,000 British Marines on board. There were about 10 other smaller vessels following his ship's lead. Each one had about 500 British Marines, 250 foreign Marines, 20 builders, 5 contractors, and some of the world's top scientists. All 11 ships had wives, husbands, and also children on board. He had to bring so many people so the human race can start again in a realm where the Earth locals called the New World. Middle Earth was cleaner, fresher than their own, but the Earth scientists had redesigned most of the world's technology, so they were eco-friendly machines, but decades of pollution has stained their lands, their waters, and the air. Boring shit, dude! I'm not gonna read this anymore!
Yeah.
It's like Tolkien, but worse.
Even more.
Let's see what Naruto. Naruto has got to
be good. Yeah, Naruto has a good potential for that.
Oh, it's also M-rated!
My skill's not enough!
Naruto, the Plutonia Experiment. 8,401 words. Oh, okay, it's mostly, dialogue, so this is better.
Oh, yes, dialogue.
And summary. After Akatsuki's defeat by Naruto, he returns to Konoha to take a test to see if he is ready to be Hokage. But little does Konoha know that a certain snake rapist is watching from the forest with a horde of imps, hell knights, barons of hell, and Kami knows what all else from hell. Will Naruto, the rest of the rookie eight, make it out of this alive, or will they all perish? Naruto X Ino, pairing Naruto X Doom video game crossover. If you need a pic of any of the monsters, just look him up using Wikipedia or Yahoo Images or Google Images. Disclaimer, I do not own Naruto or Doom. I wish I did, however. I do have my rights to my OC and my friends have their rights to theirs. So this moon is mine, so back off. All you use him with permission and everything you want to use for me, credit me with or I will seek vengeance. Naruto, the Plutonia Experiment by Dustin Dan. Chapter 1. Darkness overshadows the trials. Let's see this question ask what I would do to keep relations between two allies that are at war with each other without entering the war ourselves. Bah! I've never been good at these things. Uzumaki Naruto, 21 years old, currently sitting his examination for Hokage, but seems like he's hit a little trouble. Normally, Naruto would be brash and write a random answer, but after training with Jiraiya for several days before his death, he became more calm and quick-witted and would give Narashikamaru I ran for his money. Shoki! Gah! Let's see where I would try to have a peaceful negotiation and try to make peace between both allies. ... Period. Maybe that will work. 2 HRS later. Okay, I'm dumb examiner. You know you're troublesome, right? To the examiner. You really need a catchphrase, Shikamaru. Just go to the stadium for the next test. Hi! 20 minutes later at the stadium. Kazama Uzumaki Naruto! You are here to take the second part of the test to see if you are ready to become Hokage, are you not? Hi! The next test will put you against 3 people to test you in 3 different areas. The first part of the test will be Taijutsu, and your opponent will be Rock Lee. Second part of the test will be Ninjutsu against Kakashi. The third and final part of this test will be Genjutsu against Kurenai. Do you have any questions?
I understand none of this.
I don't see the point of two
here. Tsunade asked. Hi, I have 2 questions. 1, why not test me in Kenjutsu? And 2, what about the test in Demonic Jutsu? In answer to the first one, we have no one that can test you in Kenjutsu, seeing as how Tenten is out on a mission right now and won't be back till tomorrow. And as for Demonic Jutsus, you can use them in a Ninjutsu test. Okay, let the first test begin! Meanwhile, somewhere in the surrounding forest of Konoha. Coo-coo-coo-coo. Looks like it's time to finally test my new jutsu, a portal to hell. A green portal opened up and you could see thousands upon thousands of undead things and things that should not even be imaginable. Back at the fight. Naruto let the flying rat to the head and braced himself for the sonic boom that followed. Damn, Lee's gotten a lot stronger than I would have ever thought. And this is with his weights off, so I hate to think what would happen if he used at least one of the 8 celestial gates. Is it something in the anime? Because I do not know about the anime. The sonic boom hit Naruto and almost hit him into the wall. Come on, Naruto! Kick his ass! Shanaru! Said the pink fantasy. Forehead, do you have to scream so loud? I think you might have made Akamuru dev now. The blonde expert said. What was that, Ino pig? Nothing. Come on, Naruto-kun, you can do it! Ino yelled. Leave it to Ino-chan and Sakura to be chillada stebayo. What? Naruto-kun refocused on Lee after hearing his girlfriend and his sister cheer him on. Hey, Lee, hang on a sec. Okay, man, Lee must be taking Guy's death pretty hard. Maybe if we all go out, he might cheer up. But first, hey, need to write music for this. A and when you see this text, it in the middle of a story, it will tell you which song is gonna come up. And I may throw in my own original songs and some mixes that I did, so be watchful.
Songs?
His own songs! What say you to a little music to get our blood and our youthful flames going good and find an aura of Maito Guy? Everyone starts thinking, is he trying to get himself left? Yosh, Naruto-kun, your youthful years knows no bounds, so I say yes, let's find some music of your chosen aura of Guy Sensei!
What the
f- Alright,
here. What does this mean?
Naruto performs a couple hand skills. Ninbo, music director jutsu. Music starts playing through the stadiums. Speakers loud enough for people in the stands to hear it, but still hear the fighters and the announcer. Music starts. Boom by P.O.D. This is where we happen to find it somewhere and listen to which song is listed here. Lyrics courtesy of http://www.utterlyrics.com. Note that this is spelled out. I didn't like do it for jokes. This is actually spelled out as :// Lee, I want you to go all out and use two gates, okay? If you do that for me, I will make sure you're not disappointed. Yosh, Naruto-kun, I will! Unfortunately, both get into a similar position. Lee gets in the gate release position and yells, 8 gates release! Oh, fuck. Gate 1, initial gate, release! Gate 2, heal gate, release! Naruto got in a position similar to Lee's, but his fisted palms faced him instead of the enemy. Jiraiya Secret Seal Arts, 3 level 1 and 2, release! I never knew that a kid like, oh, this is just POD lyrics. Naruto and Lee were surrounded by malevolent air and chakras as they both finished and put their hands down. More POD. Naruto and Lee stood there waiting for the right moment to start as Lee fell into the stadium and slowly started to fall to the ground between the two fighters. More POD. The Lee hit about the time the last line finished and they disappeared and reappeared without a sound, stopped by each other's hits and stalemate and disappeared and reappeared. Somewhere else with their legs blocking each other's kicks without a sound, and there was a rush of wind and a loud BOOM! Here comes the BOOM! Ready or not! Here comes the voice from and so on. During the second line of the chorus, you see them do the same thing but with their other limbs that they didn't use the first time. And that same as before, the rush of wind and the sonic boom hit at the right times. How are you feeling, Lee? Pretty improbable already? Yes, I am, Naruto-kun. I especially like the song we are fighting to. You must teach the rest of our comrades how to use that jutsu so they can have the same experience. Then it stands everyone that was watching, including the Hokage, felt their heart rate go up and felt the adrenaline flowing through their veins. Unfortunately, all good things must come to an end as a huge explosion rocked to Konoha from the North Wall. Naruto and Lee were back to normal at the explosion and looked north with, damn it, why the hell this is always whoever it is, I'm going to kill him. The wind blew from the north, carrying a scent to Naruto's nose, and he smelled something that made him extremely pissed. Naruto. God damn it, fucking pedophilic snake rapist! Apparently there's some kind of criminal called the Snake Rapist.
That's...
Everyone that heard him
knew
who he was talking about. Apparently, I don't know. Everyone that heard him knew who he was talking about and immediately fell over it, laughing their asses off. At the same time at the North Wall. Orochimaru! Blushed and then got really, really, really pissed. How did he know? No matter, I'll make sure he is there this time along with Tsunadihime. Back at the stadium. One of the Anbu was looking at the North Wall when a fireball came out of nowhere and nearly hit him in the head. What the fuck? He said as he looked back, as the look back where it came from, and saw something that was around the corpse reanimated poorly and probably stunk like one too. But he didn't get the smell, because the next thing here that he remembered was looking at his face and feeling the heat of a miniature sun. Rutul looked up where the Anbu was stationed and thought, good fucking question. QB got any idea what this is? Aw, hell! That bad, huh? You have no idea what they can do and what all kinds of creatures like them are there are. You mean there's more than just this? Yes, these creatures are called imps. They basically will claw your ass to death or they kill you with a fireball. I think it's the same temp as the sun. No wonder that Anbu guy doesn't have a head anymore. Hey, and I think I'll end it there so that way I can see if anyone would enjoy reading this or not. If not, then I'm gonna still do it anyways because I want to. Oh, that's God. The end of the first of four chapters.
Oh. No!
I'm not gonna do this anymore.